Hey everybody, this is Hardwell and you're watching Revealed TV. When I was here 4 years ago at Creamfields for the first time, I remember I was playing the smallest stage on the festival. Max capacity was 200 people. One of the first international festivals I played, and it was an incredible experience. Let me take you all the way. When I started Revealed Recordings 4 years ago, I never could dream about how big it is right now in every single way. Hosting an area on a festival, you know, one of the biggest festivals in the world, even like all the releases, you know, on Beatport, almost every release ends up in the top 10, and it's incredible what kind of journey we've been through in the last 4 years. Plans for Revealed next year are definitely doing more with Revealed TV. We're gonna do like a lot of episodes on YouTube. Besides that, we're gonna have a lot of Revealed label nights worldwide. We're now hosting the stage at Creamfields. We're definitely gonna do more festivals in the future. Definitely looking for more talents. We have a lot of EPs coming up for upcoming guys like Joey Dill, Julian Calor, and Kill the Bus. And currently, I'm working on my artist album, which is gonna be released on Revealed as well.
What I was doing exactly 1 year ago, sitting on my couch, trying to make new music, that was it. Nothing really. Hey, this is Kill the Bus and you're watching Revealed TV. Broken hearts can feel so sharp, but mine has silver linings. Yeah, Life is Calling was a cool collaboration to do with Joeysuki.
When we created the track, we immediately heard that the vocal was really catchy, really for radio, so we decided to make a video of it.
We had a lot of airtime on the radio. We had even interview and a live set on the radio. That was good, national radio.
On the Radio 538 together with Kill the Bus. And well, that was great to do as well.
Revealed Recording is more than just a label for me. It's more like a friend thing, it's more a family, and
it's a label that takes things to the next level. It does things that normal labels don't do, and things like extra promotion for your track. So I think it's one of the biggest labels in the scene, maybe the biggest, and yeah, it's really looking into the future.
What's up, you guys? It's Deorro here, and you're watching Revealed TV. Well, my song Yi was originally a free download. I knew that we can give it out free and then also put it in a new field where people can only find it there. Hardwell was actually the only person who believed that. You know, he saw that and he believed in the track. It's like, that's my idol right there. You know what I'm saying? That's like, that's respect. He's risking it. You know, he's willing to try risks. And moving forward is all about risking, you know? When Yi came out, I can't deny it. Like, I like escalated with more recognition all around. You know, people were saying Deorro, Yi. And the fact that it was a free track, for a big risk like that, and then a result like that, it's like, I'm so happy, you know?
Thomas Newson, and you're watching Revealed TV.
This song is a collaboration between our Dutch brother Thomas Newson, Revealed Recordings. We're gonna get him up on stage. Who's ready to hear some fresh music? Make some fucking noise! Here we go!
I have a new collaboration coming up at the Futuristic Polar Bears. We premiered it actually today.
So we're really excited to do a collaboration with Thomas Newson. We met him back in Liverpool. We had a great time with him. And then we decided to do a track together. He's a really talented guy. His productions are amazing. And we can't wait for the track to come out.
came in contact with Revealed like 1 year ago when I sent the first demo of Polaroid.
We made a record and we sent it into the talent pool, which millions, I mean thousands of other producers do it. And then the next day we got an email saying they absolutely love it. And Hardwell was going to drop it at Tomorrow World. And we were in the studio going, ah! It was insane, man.
Never better way, but we do it like this.
It's not often you can send in demos to a label and it's going to the number one producer and DJ in the world and you're getting critical feedback that literally is just changing our production and making us better all the time.
Creamfields! My name is Jordy Dazz. If you're having a great time, make some noise!
It just feels like Revealed is homecoming, you know, and the team around it is just so professional, and like all the guys who I'm in contact with, like behind the scenes with the label, also the social media guys, they're just all doing an amazing job. My biggest tip for aspiring DJs and producers is make sure you make music that really is close to your heart and not try to copy other ones' music.
Who's ready to go? Fucking crazy!
Me and Thomas Newson, we already started something in the studio, which we're gonna finish in September. And I'm gonna be in the studio with Julian Calor as well, which I think can turn out like pretty interesting.
Hi, this is Julian Calor, and you're watching Revealed TV. When I'm not on the road, I wake up, I make music, I eat, and I go to bed. That's it. I started producing 7 years ago. I made hip-hop beats for like 4 years. And then I started experimenting with EDM stuff like drum and bass, house, trance. Now I'm working on my house music for like 3 years now. One year ago I was sending demos to you guys and this was a great year. It was really overwhelming and I've never expected to be here right now. What I have planned for the coming months on Revealed is something that I've worked really hard on. It's my new artist album. It's a solo album with 12 tracks, so that's I'm really excited about. What we can expect on the album is tracks like Typhoon in that kind of style, but also new experimental stuff, slower tracks, tracks with indie vocals and a lot of other stuff, so it's gonna be really cool.
Hey, what's up? My name is Dyro and you're watching Revealed TV. I came into first contact with Revealed probably around 3 years ago. I was producing music for my bedroom and decided to put some stuff up on SoundCloud. And one way or another, Hardwell found my tracks and started playing them. So I contacted him and his management. Yeah, Hardwell kind of took me under his wing from there and we started touring together, making music together. So that's kind of how I got in contact with Revealed. What I hate to hear is repetitive stuff. People try to produce music to what the crowd wants to hear instead of what they want to hear themselves. And I think that's where I like set a boundary for myself. I want to do something different. I want to create music for myself and for my fans. And other than that, yeah, quality over quantity.
Creamfields, this is my last song, so this is your last chance to get fucking crazy. Are you guys ready?
I recently started my own imprint Wolf because I had a lot of music lying around that wasn't fitting for Revealed, and we decided to take a chance and start another label in that. I'm planning on doing music on Revealed for the entire year still, and even after that, so I think the next song can be expected in a couple months.
Yo, we're the Sick Individuals.
And you're watching Revealed TV.
Our sound in three words. Every time we come back to Revealed. Yeah, that's our mother.
That's true.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Our mother. Revealed is our mother.
Well, we have a lot of plans on Revealed, so that's amazing. Well, we have our new track coming up, Lost and Found. We worked on it for a pretty long time, right? Yeah. For, I think, 2 months.
And the vocal came from a guy in LA, and we knew him for a long time, and we were writing and sending vocals back and forth, and then he sent this idea, and we were like, wow, this is amazing. So we changed the melody a bit, and then Lost and Found was born.
Feel the walls closing in, building up, stacking.
There are so many big labels right now, and I think Revealed is like a boutique label. It's more like it's run by not that many people, and then Hardwell's checking every single release. He's mastering themselves, or he's involved in everything, and I think that's kind of unique in the Revealed Recordings label.
If you guys are ready for some new Sick Individuals music on Revealed Recordings, raise your hands up high!
We wanted to make more progressive tracks because we feel that there's a need of more, well, love in the scene. Like, you have to, like, feel it. There's a lot of hard bangers out there right now that are amazing, but we feel that there's definitely need for more progressive at the moment. What's really cool about Revealed is that they're really open-minded for the tracks that we're making right now. So if we make a progressive track or a track that is a massive banger, it doesn't matter for Revealed. It has to be good, you know?
Hey guys, what's up? My name is Dannic and you're watching Revealed TV.
Everyone knows Day Alive, but to me it was just an instrumental track that was laying there for a few months and I just didn't know what to do with it. So my management and I, we sent it out to some vocalists and we got like 4 or 5 really good vocals in return. But I didn't know that my management sent it to Bright Lights as well. So I was actually like choosing from those 4 vocals that I got. But then this Bright Lights vocal came in and I was like, oh, okay, yeah, this is it, she nailed it. I got a new collaboration with Shermanology, which is coming out. It's called Wait For You. It's actually the follow-up for Day Alive. Of course, the remix package for Day Alive is coming. So a lot of new tunes coming up.
What would like Creamfields to want to see us as live as possible? Come on!
It's always good to have like remixes for your track because it does its purpose for other markets as well. So usually we get like a trance remix so the trance people can enjoy it. So we have different types of genres to choose from. I think that's really the big value for remixes.
Hey, this is W&W, and you're watching Reveal TV.
That was actually funny. I think the first contact we had with Robert, like he called you out of nowhere about like a bootleg we did for, what was it?
For Delirium Silence. And I got this call from a strange number I didn't know, and I was like, what the hell is this? So I didn't answer, and then I got a text. Hey, it's Hardwell, call me back, I want to ask you something.
He wanted to play it as Sensation or something, and after that, I think the first track we did on Reveal was a collab with Marshall Woods' Trigger.
Yeah.
And after that, a lot more, of course.
Honored to close the reveal stage at Creamfields. The crowd here has been amazing all day. We're just waiting for those people, the hardcore people that are still gonna be here, which we're gonna go in like it's peak time.
Creamfields, are you ready for some fucking new music? Let me see you make some noise!
In reverse, I change the tides, waiting for the sun to rise.
I think my biggest tip for upcoming producers would be, if you don't sign your track to the biggest label, even if you sign it to a smaller one, still do that, because I think you need to have music coming out that you can get feedback from, and then you can work up to the bigger labels later. And I think that's it, you need that just for self-assurance and just to build it up, you know. So,
you know, believe it or not, I think most people check out the music that you're sending them, and as soon as they hear something they like, they'll hit you back. That happened with Robert, you know, with the Colorblind remix, you know, he hit that back and straight away he was saying he fucking loved it, and I think that's, you just gotta keep on going.
Yeah, we both live together, we both make music, we're both great cooks, so it works, you know.
We each have our bedrooms. In each bedroom there's a studio as well, and we both have them linked up, so we'll be working on one project, we'll send it over to him, you know, he'll do a bit, throw it back, and you know, it's a sound clash, so it's like, who can be the loudest?